That's crazy. So how can somebody get into the market if they want to buy for the first time? What would you suggest, especially during this time?
So I would suggest a couple of things, right? There's a saying in the real estate market right now that home buyers have to drive until they can afford to buy. Because again, like the Greater Toronto is so expensive that that basically you just gotta drive to whatever location in which that you can afford.
Yeah, because
So that's
everyone is going out west. I have a few friends that just bought places out in like Hamilton or even a little bit further than that.
Yeah, no, it's absolutely crazy because I'll give you an example. So like last year, I had a couple of investors. So they got something in Niagara, right? So in Niagara, for an example, you could have purchased like a bungalow, 5 bedrooms, for like 400,000, 450. I have a client that now wants to purchase out there. That same top property that cost 400,000 last year, now like I couldn't find it. I couldn't find anything in the 500s. So like now they're going to 600. You know what I mean?
In
So
Niagara
like,
region.
yeah, Niagara region. You know what I mean? So like literally like everywhere, you're seeing like these price increase and you're seeing like these appreciations. So so that's one thing I suggest to home buyers is literally drive them until you can afford to buy. Another thing that I always recommend for homeowners to do is literally pool your resources with other people. I know, like I know everyone wants to have their privacy and everyone wants to do their own thing and wants to be independent. But at the same time, it's like when you pool your resources with other people, you're increasing your purchasing power. And also it becomes more feasible to be able to maintain the property. You know what I
And
mean?
pay off
So
the mortgage.
yeah, pay off the mortgage. And the thing with real estate nowadays is that you don't really have to hold it for a long time. It's a short-term compromise in order to get the things, in order to get what you want down the road.
My people within in the black community, we gotta do that because other communities are doing it. Like other communities are doing it, like you said, they're pooling their monies, they're gathered together their resources together, and they're buying up property, and that's how they do it. And then they move in, a whole bunch of them move in for a period of time, they pool their money together, they pay off the property. They buy more, they buy more, they buy more. Like, that's how a lot of members of different communities are doing it.
And it's important because like once you start doing that, you start to be able to build your legacy where it's like you now have a foundation which then you could pass down to your kids and to your kids' kids. You know what I mean? So that like it's so important that especially millennials, you know what I mean? It's younger people, we need to adapt creative strategies in order to create wealth for ourselves and really build that foundation.
So how